Hi guys. When I asked where you'd like to go next, Harris Liedekis suggested we take a tour of Nyamirambo. Just a quick trigger warning before we set off on this ride. I will be talking about the red field in Nyamirambo, which relates to 94. So if you don't want to hear about that, I will warn you before I start talking. Just pause the video and click on the timestamp in the comments to skip over it. So Nyamirambo is a pretty famous area of town. It's the oldest part of town and the Muslim quarter. It's also known for its nightlife and clothes shops, and for its banana beer brewing nuns. The main drag is two one-way streets either side of a mosque, so we're just looping around the bottom of the mosque now. Some impressive wooden scaffolding. So this is the mosque at the bottom of the high street. Now we're making our way up the main drag. Right used to be covered in fairy lights. It's a nice place to sit and watch the world go by. Official Kigali tour bus. I've never been on it, but it looks cool. And a game of basketball on the right. say that Nyamirambo has been gentrified, but it's definitely a lot tamer than it used to be. It looks really nice now, but maybe it's missing a little bit of its old character. Guys, I'm about to talk about the red field. If you don't want to hear about that, pause the video here and click on the timestamp in the comments. Just behind this posh bus stop, you'll see a patch of ground. It's an old football pitch outside Nyamirambo Stadium. In 1998, 4 years after the genocide, a group of people were executed here for their participation in the atrocities. I've put a couple of links below if you want to read more about that. But the actions of that day led to a dramatic change in direction for Rwanda. There was a realisation that the country couldn't move forward peacefully if it implemented an eye for an eye policy. And so they adopted Gacaca reconciliation hearings instead of executions. The death penalty was officially abolished in 2007. The entrance to Nyamirambo Stadium, which holds around 22,000 people. This little grey tower on the right is what a speed camera looks like in Rwanda, and they are everywhere. Bit of an emotional journey for me. Back when I was a VSO, one of my closest friends, Martine, used to live up here, and I would travel right across the city to come and visit her. Back then, this was all cobblestones and ladies selling fruit on the pavement. I was in my 20s at the time and still remember the rush of flying through the night on a Moto with my shawl flapping out behind me. They were really good times. I think that blue gate there was her house. And that building site there is where we used to go for beer and brochettes. There was Sun City Hotel, and then there was a big wooden resto called Panorama. They did great fish brochettes, and you could sit upstairs with an amazing view of the whole city. I'm kind of sad it's gone. Did a spot of bird watching as there was a giant stork preening itself on the rooftop.